What's up, YouTube? Another question for y'all today was, John, when would you recommend using Lantus in the off-season period? And so I'm not giving a recommendation of, hey, this is what you should do, but I'll give you some ideas around when this might be being deployed in a bodybuilding situation. And you know, the issues around enhanced bodybuilding is that you're in a progressive state where food is increasing, overall training stress is increasing, and you're also progressively usually using more growth hormone, and body weight is increasing well. So all these variables increasing along the way increases inflammation in the body and can set you up for more insulin resistance occurring. And that increases the need for insulin production. And so when you have that high demand for insulin, and we're talking, this is getting to a more unsustainable amount, and that chronic exposure to high serum insulin levels can potentiate that effect on insulin resistance. And the enhanced bodybuilder can share a very similar metabolic profile to someone that has metabolic syndrome, where they have visceral fat gain, insulin resistance, and dyslipidemia occurring. And so that's all similarities of what we share. And one of the first line strategies within this population can be a deployment of Lantus in preserving beta cell function. Now, we're not getting to a level that might be as deranged as someone that has like a metabolic syndrome. However, you are still putting a significant amount of strain on pancreatic beta cells to put out insulin. So Lantus would come into play at a time when you're exposing yourself to escalation of these variables. So this would be once you're entering into your push-up phase, where food's going to be increasing, you're now increasing your PEDs and body weight's getting driven up. Lantus would be deployed as a prophylactic means to help your body manage the overall insulin and glucose load that you're going to be imposing. And so within this, it's going to be, for one, improving your glucose control. So your high demand of already of insulin, adding that other insulin in, makes your body own production more effective and can improve insulin sensitivity, because insulin itself also has some good antioxidant, anti-inflammatory properties within it. And then, you know, preserving that beta cell function. Also what I find when guys go back into like a holding phase where food's getting pulled down, PEDs are getting pulled down, and maybe you're going to move into a fat loss phase from there, is that everything works a lot faster. In other words, like body fat will come off if that's part of your next plan. You don't have this delay in that holding phase of like, okay, we need to get this guy like more insulin sensitive and kind of reset everything. It picks up a lot faster. So you become more productive into your next phase a lot sooner out the gate. Also, you're able to preserve health a lot more in that push-up phase, to where you're also not needing that holding phase to be as long to reestablish those health markers. So that's when I would use a Lantus application, or when you're seeing guys using it, is in the initial phases of when they're doing that push-up. And you know, usually deployment for Lantus is 0.02 IUs per kilogram of body weight. So if you're a 100 kilogram individual, it's usually starting point of 20 IUs. Now, this is a starting point in diabetics that are all already insulin resistant. So this is not the starting point that I recommend. This is a starting point that they're usually using in diabetics. So I think a conservative 50% of that is a starting point, a 0.01 IU per kilogram of body weight. So 10 IUs could be a starting point, and then moving it up as needed. But again, we don't want to get to a point where you're getting way beyond what might be deployed as the starting point in diabetics. Because if you're getting it to a point where you're needing 40 plus IUs of Lantus, you're still having a lot of insulin resistance occur in the background. Health is getting really diminished in that state, and you're going to have a high requirement for a very long holding phase, health restoration phase, whatever you like to call it. That's going to be really suboptimal, and you're going to just grow better being in an overall healthy state. So I would not progress it up beyond that point. Just have it in as a prophylactic strategy, and don't use it beyond that means. So anyway, let me know if you have further questions on Lantus deployment, and I will talk to you next time.